All right. I think what I have to do today has to be a bit in here. Okay, so what we have for data, if I remember correctly. Oh, it's down here. Right, so what we have for data is a disk file name. Now, to take an interrupt, I would have to be able to read and write to such a file. I'm debating on whether or not I should use a F stream or if I should read everything from an F stream and put it into a buffer that I read from. What I might do is I might have a vector. The idea is that when I'm reading from that stream, I could put into here. Oh, I'm probably going to add another flag. Be a while loop. I might have to add another thing for non type. The idea being that exit behavior will be called on I shouldn't set this to zero because some things might not set this, and I should at least have the definition. Just like this, because not everything uses a initial data stream. I don't like that. There we go. That's good. However, we don't do anything with the word yet, so. I do need to look something up. Okay, I guess that's not gonna work. In any case, what was it that I was... Disk data. Let's see. IO position is 0000001, and then IO length is 0003, should be 0002. Reason why I'm casting it to a UN64 is so that way when adding, if this is the 32-bit limit, which it really should not be, you can still read 65,535 bytes past it. I pause and I length are stored here. Yeah, they're stored here. Okay, so when I go down here, they should already theoretically be set. And they do have default values, which means I can use them safely. this will break out of this, which means that any remaining bytes will just be the same as when they begun. I'm thinking to test this, I need to go back in here. Not there. Man, it has been a little while since I've. Why is this all messed up? I have no idea why this is like that. Okay. All right, so, right, to begin, I would have to add another, I'd probably also have to fix some something in here. All right, step systems, right, so anything that required system ID to be over here is now wrong. UN32, UN32, UN16. UN32, UN32, UN16, UN16. Okay. at exec breakpoint. Double check that one. It is incorrect. And it's U16, U16, U32, U8. Or is it U8, U16? It is. Did I already have this defined then? I did. I think everything else is the same though. Wait, hold on. This is incorrect though. In any case, I think I got everything down. And I can go on with set in the data. The void, UN32, UN32, voltage char. Let me double check something. Send data. It should end at a. It should be null terminated, right? Yeah, it terminates at 0, 0. Right, but currently I need to have add device to system. This is a U32 return with, don't need a whole lot of this right now. See, U32 return, U32 parameter, and U8 parameter. Oh wait, hold on, it's in here. There we go, just in case. There we go. I should then go ahead and create. Should see something like this, if I did everything correctly. So first thing I need to do is I need to let me open up CPU again. I think the first thing I need to do is interrupt, which since I start out unprotected, won't be too hard. 0402. For now, I'm going to clear out everything. I think I should be able to I think I should be able to do this in one run. Okay, so so I go ahead and send an interrupt, and what I want to send an interrupt to is the MMC. Probably want to check system to find out what exactly the values that I have to attach are. Oh, to be completely honest, I am very confused on what this does. If the first processor, if the IRQ out variable of the first processor modulo 2 is equal to 1, which would be the same as saying the least significant bit, then mem manager equals mem manager or 1, or rather mem manager and min equals nmin or 1. Okay, so that would set NMI flag. Mem manager I param 1 would equal processor 0 I IRQ param 1. And the same thing goes for IRQ param 2. If processor out and 0x8000 equals 0x8000, then NMI in. Why is it both the lowest and highest bits? Doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. Maybe I can find the reason in. There doesn't seem to be anything here that reacts to the highest bit being set. So I think I want to set the lowest bit. Then I need to set the wait, hold on. Need to set these bits. I think I'm gonna have to interrupt like 3 times. So I'm gonna have to send a 004 as a param. And the other thing that I want is to set to set this bank. So 002. Right, then Wait, it's this one that I need to set. Then at last, two, that's four. That is, wait, hold on. There we go. That's an even number. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, which then is 6 words. I might need to do the interrupt down here. Probably one lower. Okay, so to interrupt a device. We need to have a parameter of 8. Then this parameter doesn't matter since the disk device doesn't care for it. We have two interrupts. We need three moves. No, we need more moves than that since we need to move stuff into a register than into memory. Actually, we can start by having three direct memory 0x0003. What was the first 2 bytes? I believe they were an offset. Right, so we just need to set these two to 0, and then set this one to 6. And since the register starts out with a value of 0, we'll be good. Wait, no, hold on. I think I have this wrong. Yeah, I think I have this wrong. These need to be swapped. This won't actually do anything. Then I'm going to set a breakpoint at 0x40. That should get me to the point where this will tell me what's at, what's right there. Actually, I should go ahead. I might be able to reconstruct the string. What is the last part of? I have this all wrong, don't I? I have to move all of these over. All right, let's look. Yes, I do. painful. Right. Poke memory requires system ID, then bank, then address, then data. So I need to move this over and this all the way here. Zero two zero one zero two zero four zero two zero zero. I have to change that too, but that's easier. is just going to be just nothing happening here. Okay. All right, let's see. Seems like it's stuck somewhere. All right, let's see. Hold on. Okay, didn't load. Wait, that doesn't do anything for me. Never mind. Okay. All right, so add device to system did not work. And I'm assuming it set init data also didn't. Let me double check. Is this compiled? Okay. All right, time for break. So, to begin. First, I should probably move this. Oh, from here to here. Okay. First breakpoint right here. Probably not going to be the first for very long because I'm going to make a breakpoint right here. Then here and here. No, wait, not here. But here. I will make one there. All right, here seems to be a bigger problem. It seems like it might be running indefinitely. Threads. We are well in advance to where we should be. Seems I have something wrong somewhere, that a breakpoint is not indeed being set. So let's take a look. We start. Okay. All right, I get it. Okay. So system ID, processor ID, then address bus. That for a second said 4,000. But I'm also going to set this to 38. Is this reflected in breakpoint? Endpoint. Ah, breakpoint. U1 32, U1 8, U1 16. It is. So this is correct. Okay. I'm guessing nothing was detected. Oh, right. Okay, so this would be zero. Mean, I was wrong, I suppose. Still nothing. Am I getting this correct? Okay. So we go into here. What we do is first, I want to open that. Second, I should close that. Then here. Was not good. It doesn't look like it hits that part. What are the errors here? And then my in is 0. Hold up. Okay. I see my error. First, I should put a break there, but second, more importantly, in here, and now I need to change something to from 0, 0 to 0, or from 0A to 0A. Second, if I could. Let's see. Okay, maybe now it'll work. Seems like I have the wrong thing. Okay, let's see this. It's wrong. All of them are wrong for some reason. which they should not be. ID was 2. Is this wrong? Is there code back here that is wrong? I think there's code back here that is wrong. I think what I did was I returned size, but not size minus 1. Okay, so we got some data back, but I don't think it's correctly loaded. Okay, and okay, I'm going to. I'm going to get rid of a bunch of these. Seems like an interrupt doesn't get to it. I'm gonna put an interrupt back here. Right, any case. Okay, I see, I forgot that I had to set the I prime to something. This data was zero. Is this the same disk? All right, well, I had fun trying to figure that out. That's going to be it for tonight. If you're watching the if you're watching the stream, thank you. If you're watching later on YouTube, thank you. That's going to be it for me. So until I see you again, this is goodbye.